Welcome to ECN Trade Daily Video. Before we begin, it should be noted that any advice is of a general nature only, and that your personal circumstances have not been taken into consideration.
Hello everyone, my name is Rob Clayton and thank you for joining me. After posting 10 consecutive days, the Australian dollar has finally found a temporary base, seen around 63.65, and from there it's slowly climbing out of its oversold conditions, well, to the point extreme oversold conditions. As the bears continue to muscle in and weigh on the market, questions now may be assessing whether the bears have pushed the market too far due to how oversold it is from a daily and also from a weekly, and therefore could see a slightly further case this week. Looking towards the top side, resistance is seen as 64.35 as minor and 64.70. But if the market can clear those two levels, then we may be on track to see a rise back to 66 cents. They still have a lot of work to do. And looking to how the current pattern looks, the market needs to at least clear that 64.70. Otherwise, further pressure might return back to this base seen around 63.65. Adding to the negative tone, China's economic data has painted a mixed outlook, as retail sales last week were weaker than expected. Imports and exports also plunged, and business activities stalled. Meanwhile, looking ahead, all eyes look to this year's hottest event, which is the Kansas City Fed's Jackson Hole Economic Policy Symposium in Wyoming. This is when the US Federal Reserve invites central banks and economic policymakers worldwide to discuss markets and global economy. This year's event theme is structural shifts in the global economy. Eyes will be looking mainly on US Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell when he is scheduled to speak this Friday on August the 25th. Powell will unlikely offer specifics about any near-term monetary policy discussions. However, investors will be watching closely for hints about whether the July Fed rate hike was the last one of the current cycle, or will the US Central Bank could pivot from rate hikes to rate cuts. Still, there's a lot to be discussed upon, so all eyes on Jackson's whole economic policy symposium. Moving on to the euro, the market still remains somewhat negative. And as we can see, the support level still holds clearly at 107.75.85, or as a trajectory, since this bearish trend started around 112. Looking at the first support, comes in around 108.45. But I feel that towards this bottom side of the range could see a bullish response. Looking to the top side, resistance comes in around 109.25 to 109.70. Looking at the dollar yen, the market has peaked, and from the peak is now slowly staging a light pullback and easing the RSI out of its overbought conditions. In view of the RSI, though, it has confirmed just now that the negative outlook could actually continue and therefore look towards the region as a potential target of 144.60.70 and reassess from there. The pound has grinded slowly to the upside and now at this point still looks towards that key point at 127.80 to 128.20. A break there would give further upside and also confirm the target of 130. But there's a lot of work to do on the top side, but I like the way these technicals are shaping up to the bullish case. So I'm not negative in comparison of maybe the Australian dollar and the euro. Support at this stage is seen around 126.60 to 126.80. Keeping in a down channel, gold is still weighing heavily and still very much on track to the challenge of 1850.70 area. I feel with a strong trend that's in place, although a little bit overheating, could see the market eventually reach its objective, but we are a little bit oversold, so therefore any upside attempts should be contained around 1910.11 with the immediate target to the downside of 1884, and as mentioned, with the base holding at 1850.70. Wrapping up with oil, the market has rebounded and currently on track to a target somewhere around 80.90 to about 82.5. I like the way the market did reach its objective around 78.80, and from there the market has now rebounded and holding to a steady stance. Well, that's a wrap. Thank you very much for joining me, and as always, look out for the intraday report. I hope you enjoy the great start to the new week.